Hi everyone, welcome to Bodyworks Prime. Today we're going over the origin, the insertion, and the action of the iliacus muscle.
Pictured here, you can see the iliacus muscle in isolation, and you can see it's connecting the hip to the femur. And the iliacus muscle is one of the three iliopsoas muscles. The other two are the psoas major and the psoas minor. So I've just brought the psoas major and minor into view. The psoas major is the largest muscle, and the psoas minor is the smaller one here. So you'll notice the psoas minor is more superficial than the major, meaning it's close to the skin surface. The psoas major is more superficial than the iliacus, meaning the psoas major is closer to the skin surface. You'll also notice as the psoas major comes down here, it merges together with the fibers of the iliacus muscle. So as they merge together, they both form a common tendon, and this common tendon is what connects onto the lateral trochanter of the femur. Another thing to note about the iliopsoas muscle group is that the psoas minor is connecting onto the hip itself. It's connecting onto the iliopectineal eminence and pectineal line, whereas the psoas major and the iliacus are both crossing over the hip joint. I think this is perhaps the reason why some sources don't include the psoas minor as part of the iliopsoas muscle group, but the overwhelming majority of sources which I've looked at include the psoas minor as part of the iliopsoas muscle group, so for this video I'm going to include it as part of the iliopsoas muscle group as well. Another important thing to remember about the iliopsoas muscle group is its relation to the inguinal ligament. So the inguinal ligament is a nice landmark to remember, and it's this band of connective tissue which it connects onto the anterior superior iliac spine and comes down here and connects onto the pubic tubercle. You'll notice that the psoas major and the iliacus are both passing underneath this inguinal ligament as they travel down towards the femur. If you'd like to learn more about the psoas major and the psoas minor, I'll put links in the description box below so you can go and click on them afterwards and check out their individual videos too. So let's take a look at the origin next. You can see I've got that marked out here in red. That's going to be the superior two-thirds of the iliac fossa. So the iliac fossa is just the smooth and concave surface of the ilium here. The lower third would be the portion which I haven't highlighted here. So it's going to be in that superior two-thirds of that iliac fossa. Now you'll also notice that it's kind of branching onto the iliac crest here as well. So the crest would be the top of the ilium here, and the red area is just touching on that. So the inner lip of the iliac crest is going to be part of that origin as well. You'll also notice that the red area also crosses onto the lateral aspect of the sacrum here. Sacrum would be this big bone here, so it's crossing onto the lateral aspect of the sacrum as well. But the main origin point, which you really need to remember, is just that it's originating from the superior two-thirds of the iliac fossa. That's the main bulk of where the origin is originating at. Moving on to the insertion next, you might have already guessed where that is based on my introduction earlier, and I've got it highlighted here in blue, which is on the lateral trochanter of the femur. And it's going to be that shared tendon of the iliacus and the psoas major muscle. As those fibres merge together, they're going to come down and connect onto that lateral trochanter.
So let's take a look at the actions next. And the iliacus muscle is originating in the iliac fossa here, coming down, crossing over the hip joint and connecting onto the lateral trochanter of the femur. So as it contracts, it's going to pull on the femur and lift the leg up just like that. So that would be flexion of the hip joint. And that's our first and primary action of the iliacus muscle. What happens if we keep both feet planted firmly on the floor? In that case, it's still going to pull on this iliac fossa, but it's just going to result in a hinging of the hips and the torso will lean forward like that. Both those actions are still flexion of the hip joint, and that flexion is going to be achieved with some help of the psoas major muscle as well, because you'll remember that the muscle fibers of the psoas major and the iliacus both come down here and connect onto the lateral trochanter of the femur. Now, an action of the psoas major muscle is external rotation of the femur. At the moment, the femur is in an internally rotated position. As it rotates outwardly, just like that, that would be external rotation of the femur. Now, I found a couple of websites which stated that the iliacus muscle was an external rotator of the femur as well. When I've gone and looked at the published research on the subject, I wasn't able to verify this anywhere. And I suppose if you look at where the iliacus is originating right here, it's a more vertical line of pull towards that insertion right here, but the psoas major is originating more towards the midline, so it's a bit more of an advantageous position to cause that external rotation of the femur. So because I wasn't able to find any research to support it being an external rotator, I'm not going to include it as an action in this video. As far as I'm concerned, the iliacus muscle is a flexor of the hip joint, just like that, and that's its primary action. So if you want to check out my videos on the psoas major or the psoas minor, I'll put links in the description box below. Obviously, both those muscles in combination with the iliacus muscle are muscles of the iliopsoas muscle group. And if you've enjoyed this video or you found it helpful, you know which buttons to press. Press that like, subscribe, leave a comment, let me know what you thought of the video. Thanks again for watching, everyone. I'll see you all next time.